Hey guys, it's Denise Salcedo, and I am at Festival of Honor with none other than Jeff Cobb. Jeff Cobb, this is the second time we meet again.
I'm back. Wait, don't move. Look that way. Oh, there it is. Yeah.
Okay. There we go.
Guys, what's up?
You know, I got to tell you, I'm so excited for you because we were just talking about, what, a few months ago, and we were talking about, you know, it still kind of seemed a little bit far, the MSG show and all of that stuff, but now we are literally, what, less than 24 hours away from the show. We're at the Hulu Theater right now, but I want to know, what is the anticipation? How are you feeling right now knowing that you are going to be performing in MSG?
It's very nerve-wracking. I watched it as a kid, watched WrestleMania 1 here, or, you know, I don't want to give shout-outs to other companies, but I did watch it, and, you know, I have it on tape, and oh my gosh, as a kid, I was like, oh, this is awesome. And now I'm here getting to throw people around the Madison Square Garden.
Crazy.
Have you been able to go and look at the stage and look at the setup?
I haven't been up there yet.
Not yet?
Yeah, I'm kind of worried. Like, you know, it's like when you get married, you see your bride before she walks down the aisle. That might be a little bit. I don't know. I might maybe just like pop. I don't know what to do.
So let me get this straight. Breaking news: Jeff Cobb is seeing this as like a wedding day.
Oh yeah. So like when I walk down the aisle, that'll be the first time I see it, and then I start crying. Oh, don't get a close up on that Ring of Honor, guys.
That's awesome. So now, obviously, you're going to have your match against Will Ospreay, who is an incredible, incredible opponent to have. Tell me a little bit about how you feel going up against, you know, your MSG show, and you're going up against Will Ospreay.
Well, I'm very excited for the fact that it's a title for title. And, you know, my goal is to do more New Japan stuff, and I figure if I beat Will Ospreay, who actually beat me in February... In a tag match, mind you, in a tag match. If I do beat him, I do have a New Japan title, a championship around my waist, and that means I'll be going over there more often, and you know, it's just great. Like, and I believe I think New Japan released the card, or Ring of Honor released the card, where we're the first match, we're the opening match of Madison Square Garden. Sorry about the other 9 matches, and you got to follow us. So I'm excited.
It's kind of funny because, you know, everyone is obviously going to be backstage, maybe feeling like a little giddy, and like knowing that you're the first ones out there, like if he's like on the main card, it's kind of like, oh snap, you know?
Yeah, I might throw up and cry. That's horrible. Well, I might cry, then throw up, and then cry that I threw up.
Do you ever still get like pre-match jitters before you go out, or is this just because like it's Madison Square Garden?
I always get pre-match jitters, yeah.
So this is going to be like times 100.
Oh, yeah. And then some. Yeah, it's going to be crazy.
So now, I want to know, why did you challenge Will Ospreay?
Well, for the fact that he did pin me in Japan. We had the Honor Rising Tour in February, where New Japan or Ring of Honor sent some guys to New Japan, and we did 2 shows in Cork and Hall. The first night, I defended the Ring of Honor Television Championship, and then the second night, they put myself and Dalton Castle against Goto and Will Ospreay in a tag match, and Will actually pinned me. And for a while, I've been kind of chasing that Never Open Championship, and it's always like Goto beat me for it, or beat me to retain, and then Will Ospreay pinned me, and I just kind of like I sat on a thumbtack. I was angry. Angry.
There you go. And what the best way to get revenge is definitely going to be at the G1 Supercard.
Oh yeah, definitely. I had to defend my belt and make sure I made all my contracted obligations of defending the belt, and then when I was clear, I finished my last challenger at the pay-per-view, and then Will Ospreay was, you know, it was like if you got out of if you didn't win the New Japan Cup, then I challenge you for the Garden, and unfortunately for him, he didn't make it out. He made it to the semifinals, and then now he's got to face me, sucker.
Well, also, I want to know, so this is like the first year, you know, at WrestleMania where, you know, you're technically on one show, because prior to that, you know, you were working the indies and doing so many shows. Does it feel kind of weird, like, not being, like, going from show to show? I mean, obviously, you're at the big show, but, you know, like, prior, is there, like, a shift? How does it feel for you?
It's very weird. Last year, I did 8 shows, and I didn't get a chance, like, I felt like I didn't get a chance to enjoy the moment. So I'm just doing one. So yesterday we had the day off. We didn't have anything planned. So like I went to a couple shows and got to reconnect with some people I haven't seen in a while. Now that I'm not in the indies, and And then, you know, so it's like, it's great. I mean, I miss that seeing everybody, but, you know, it just makes it that much better when you get to see him finally. So.
Yeah. Is there anybody that you caught up with that you were like, you hadn't seen in a while? Anybody in specific? Yeah. Anyone you haven't met, by the way? Or have you just pretty much met everyone at this point?
I've almost met pretty much everybody. It was cool because yesterday I got to catch up with some guys that I haven't seen in a while, like from Northern California. I'm going to give them a cheap plug if that's okay with you. My buddies J.R. Kraos and Dave Dutra, John LaRocca, who got me to move from Hawaii to get out of my little bubble. Yeah, so he was a driving force in me getting out of Hawaii and then pushing me to, you know, come out and do my thing in America. Or, well, the mainland, I guess, if you will. I also got to see my buddy Tim Thatcher. We all got some pizza.
Nice. New York pizza's the best.
New York style pizza, thin crust, baby, where the oil drips. You know, I got to see my buddy Eddie Kingston. Now that I'm doing the voice. Got to see him wrestle. Who did he wrestle last night? I think it was
WrestleCon.
No. He wrestled at the AIW show.
I wasn't at that one.
Okay, yeah, Otani.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it was cool. I got to see my bud. I haven't seen him in a while. I don't know where he's really. I think he's from New York, but he lives in Orlando now. So like. Yeah, your boy. It's my Eddie Kingston impression. But yeah, I got to see so many people that I haven't seen in such a long time. It was just great to catch up with them.
Yeah, that's the fun part, you know, just kind of like, even like for like me that I'm not a wrestler, but still like catching up with the fans and like seeing people, talking to like fellow press people. It's really fun. This is a time of season where, you know, everybody kind of gets to reconnect with one another. You know, even with you, like, you know, we hadn't seen each other in a bit. So, you know, this is cool. So now my last question for you, totally random, totally off topic, but I need to know. Did you ever find your triple stuffed Oreos or double stuffed Oreos?
I think it was called Most Stuff.
Oh.
No, I did not.
No.
Yeah. Unfortunately, I tried really hard. A couple times I went to the store, the Albertsons by my house. They were sold out. Like, they had the section where it said Most Stuff, and it was empty. And I was very sad. But you know what? Now that I think about it, maybe I didn't need it. Well, actually, I wanted to get it for, like, my little brother and little sister, because they're like, oh, that's cool. Because it usually takes a while for stuff to get to the islands, and I don't think they sent that there. Which is crazy. Like, who needs that much Oreo cream?
You know what? I think you're going to find it when you least expect it.
Well, I think it was just, like, a limited run, and they're not doing it anymore.
All right,
so, Oreo. I'm sorry. Let me rephrase that. Nabisco, I know you're watching. So do me a favor and send me, like, you know, make a couple bags or whatever. It's cool. I don't mind.
Yeah, seriously, send them in because you've been waiting for a while.
Yeah.
Well, Jeff Cobb, thank you so much for talking to me today. Congratulations. Super excited to see you tomorrow. And seriously, good luck and enjoy your time here at Madison Square Garden. All right, guys, everybody, Jeff Cobb.